Well, it's one of Ireland's national sports. It's called hurling.
And in honor of St. Patrick's Day, we thought we'd find out more about it. Now we have Tracy and Brandon from the Fox River Hurling Club joining us live from Appleton with more on a special event that they're having today. Now, hi there.
Hello, Angela. Hey, hello, Doug.
Good morning.
Hi, good morning. Okay, let's first, real quickly, if you can explain what hurling is and what it means to Ireland.
Well, hurling is actually the national sport of Ireland. It's a sport that really predates written history. The Celts, of course, brought it wherever they moved to, and of course now that's pretty much Ireland. They've also, of course, brought it to the U.S. because naturally, with a lot of Irish immigrants, comes a sport.
And now you guys.
What do you
have...
imagine this is?
Oh, I don't know. Tell us.
This is a hurley. This is actually the stick that we use to hit the slitter. That's what we call the ball. It's called a slitter. And what we do with hurling is you have 15 people on a side, and the other side, of course, has 15 as well, and you try to score a goal. Now, in indoor hurling, it's a little bit different from outdoor. You can see that we've got just goals, but in outdoor, we have goal posts similar to like a football goal post, and if you hit it through the goal, like a football goal, it's worth 1 point, or in the goal, like a soccer goal, it's worth 3 points. So you can imagine that it gets to be a pretty quick game and a pretty high scoring game.
Got a quick question for you. Can you use your hands at all, or is it just the stick?
No, you can use your hands. The only thing you can't do with your hands is actually pick the ball up off the ground or throw it, like in a baseball throw. In order to pass it, use your hands to give it a hand slap, kind of like a handball.
Very cool. And I see, you know, how big is your club? I mean, is this popular here in our area?
It's becoming more and more popular. We started the club with four people in May of last year, and we decided that we had far too much free time and money on our hands, and so we decided the best thing to do with that is start a hurling club. But as you can see, it's grown quite a bit since then. You know, with the help of our sponsors and with the help of the Irish community and some of the Irish festivals, we've really attracted a lot of people. And not just of Irish descent. We've got some Germans, we've got, you know, some Poles. We've got pretty much everything that Wisconsin is made out of.
Yeah, very cool. And it looks like people of all ages. I see some youngsters out there, too. So.
That's right. That's right. Yeah. In fact, this year we're beginning our youth programs, and I've got Tracy here to... discuss our youth programs a little bit. I know she's excited about it.
Yeah, we're very excited about the youth program. We just started it this year, and we have people of all ages, as you mentioned. We have age from 4 years old to 12 years old, and we currently have about 7 players. We are very excited about the sponsorship that we've had through Prevea Health to be able to include and recruit for more children, and we are excited about recruiting for anybody. So I'm hoping that anybody out there is watching is really excited about it. The thing that having children involved as well is that it also brings a whole aspect of families into this. And this is a family game. We like to play at co-ed, and we really think that if families can play together, then it will really grow, and they'll really love to play the sport.
Fantastic. Thank you guys both for joining us, and we'll check back in with you a little bit later to learn more about hurling. Thanks, guys.
Fantastic.
Thank you.